months away. Men of the North, you see.
Spard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead.
Come on. Slow now, whoa. Move it! Come on! Hey there! Hey-ya! Move it!
Was here. One lay there, by the stump, headless. The other hung from a branch, guts splayed, stretching down to... Watch out for yourself now.
I'll be fine. Not the first griffin I've dealt with. Not likely to be the last, either.
Hope you're right. Good hunting now.
Guardians were celebrating. Griffin interrupted them. Ground's black, saturated with blood. A camp.
Come on.
Lost your key, ma'am?
No, not me key. Me pan. It always sat there empty, this hut. That is, till the night afore the battle. A man arrived, walked right in like 'twere his own. Standing at me window, peering at the goings-on. Must have read me, 'cause next I knew, there he was, coming my way. So, I grabbed me pan, for protection, see? He just asks all polite, Gran, got any birch bark by chance? Lilac berries or even a few coals? Nay, says I. And you must be right daft to pester folk at night with such foolery. And I sees he ain't listening. Just staring at me pan like a magpie at a copper. Lend it to me, Gran. I'll give it back come morn. He's right baffled for what's he doing, frying in the dark. But I've got a soft heart, so I gave it to him.
Interesting. What happened then?
Afore dawn, another rode up to the hut. But come morn, only the first fella left. Locked the door, hopped on his horse, and that were all I saw of him, and me pan. T'were old, black with soot, not worth much, I suppose. But I've no other. Will you help me, dearie? Bring an old widower pan. I could never break down that door myself. And in truth, I'm afeard to go in any road. Such a stench wafting out. Methinks the other fellow, well, that he's lying there.
Never taken on a pan contract. Fine, I'll go in, look around.
You should wait here, just in case. Show me what you got. A corpse. Explains the stench. His throat. He was garroted. And some old scars. Kind a soldier might have.
What's that, dearie?
Nothing, nothing. Documents. Almost entirely burnt. A few pieces still legible.
But when I gabbed to myself, They say I'm going barmy.
The priceless frying pan. Scrubbed clean. Looks like the mystery man didn't need the pan so much as the soot off it to make ink, write letters.
Found the pan, have you?
Here, your frying pan.
Mine? But mine were black with soot, and I could see myself in this one if I wanted. But them years are past.
It was the soot the man needed. He scraped it off to make ink. Must have had an urgent letter to write. Urgently burned some other documents, too.
And the other fellow?
Dead. Round up a few boys and bury him outside the village. Deep, so the necrophages don't dig him up. And take my advice. Don't mention this to the Nilfgaardians.
Hang about! You've earned a token of thanks. Here, sonny, for the road. Fry up a nice white fish for some. Or a pipe.
Go. Move it!
Guardians are older and deeper, heavily armored. Elf Guardians, probably.
Thank you.
Griffin's nest. What remains of it, at least. Corpse is a couple of weeks old. Still alive when the Griffin brought him here. Took a long time dying. Female. Larvae in her wounds have already hatched. Been dead at least a week. Other Griffin must be a male. Beak tips worn. Gray hairs in the coat. 10, 12 years old. Griffins pair off for life when young. Male must be about the same age. Deep cuts over the whole body. Not a drop of blood on the beak or claws. Didn't defend herself. Crept up on her while she slept. Thick shaft, dense barbs. A royal griffin. Explains why the male I ran into was so aggressive. Hunted the Nilfgaardians down here in the forest first, then started prowling the area. Done all I could. Should talk to Vesemir.
Come on now.
Giddy up. Slower.
Oh, and you find the box?
A little wet, but intact.
At last, fortune smiles my way. Yours as well, Witcher. Here, the gold I promised you. Happy trails now. Thanks once again.
Hey there.
Greetings.
A Witcher? You see the notice? Hear about the well?
A well? First I've heard. There a problem?
Aye. Tis haunted. Has been for a good 20 years.
20? So why'd you put out a notice just now?
Because earlier on we drew our water from the river. But so many corpses floating in it after the battle has turned noxious. My daughter Mandy drank half a pitcher. Felt dreadfully ill, can't keep nothing down. She grows worse by the day. Herbalist claims you fight a fever with drink. And not beer nor cider, but water. clear, pure water. And where am I to get that if not from the well? But first, the ghost's got to be driven away. And don't let any man near.
This ghost. Describe it for me.
Well, it's awful frightening. Awful.
I meant, what does it look like?
It looks like a woman, but fresh from the grave. Wears a dirty dress, all rags, its skin flaking off its bones, and it howls like it's suffering.
Some wraith, or maybe an alp.
If you don't wallop it, Master, if you don't take care of it, that is, it'll come kill me daughter.
I feel for you, but this is my job, so let's talk about my pay.
Something not right with the coin. If you could drop your price a bit, I'm sure we'd agree. If you could drop your price a bit, I'm sure we'd agree. That settles it then.
Fine, I'll help. Where's this well?
In Havel, a settlement on the heights. It's abandoned now, no one ventures there on account of the ghost being about. Drive it off. Please.
She's a fever, has fainting spells. She's in a bad way, Master, a bad way.
Come on, Roach. Take it easy.
Strange. No sign of a ghost. Maybe it only shows at a certain time of day. Grass around the well scorched. Body. Can't reach it from here. Lucky not to come up empty-handed. A bracelet with an inscription. To Claire, from Volker. Bracelet must have belonged to the woman in the well.
Thank you.
corpse, hanged by the bucket rope. Wide pelvis, small jaw. A woman. Around 30, judging by the teeth. Left arm's missing. Wide pelvis, small jaw. Journal might be useful. right pelvis, small jaw. Was she wearing the bracelet from her husband? Might be why her arm fell off. Wide pelvis, small jaw. A woman. Around 30, judging by the teeth. Left arm's missing. Was she wearing the bracelet from her husband? Might be why her arm fell off.
Thank you.
Wide pelvis, small jaw. Was she wearing the bracelet from her husband? Wide pelvis, small.